Welcome viewers to a very special segment as I'm in conversation with a gentleman who's actually responsible for putting the smile on children's faces all around the world. And he's actually a cartoonist, the author of Diary of a Wimpy Kid. As many of the parents may know, that Diary of a Wimpy Kid has been the number one bestseller in New York and actually children's most favorite book. So sitting with me in conversation is none other than Mr. Jeff Kinney himself. Let me take this opportunity to say welcome. Thank you for coming on our show.
Thanks for having me. It's very cool to be here.
It is indeed a pleasure. And as I mentioned, that Jeff Kinney has been, most of his books has actually, all of the books actually have been bestsellers, including his latest release, which is actually Diary of a Wimpy Kid, A Long Haul. Now, as we are in conversation, actually, long before Diary of a Wimpy Kid, you were actually a cartoonist. You actually illustrated your own comic strip for actually a campus newspaper. Tell us about that. Let's go back in time before Diary of a Wimpy Kid. How did all that come about?
Well, I'm actually a failed cartoonist. I wanted to be a newspaper cartoonist.
Right.
And in college, I had a strip for a few years called Igdoof.
Igdoof, right,
and
yes.
What I did was after college, I took it out into the real world, and I didn't have any takers. Nobody liked my work.
Right.
So I decided after about 3 years of trying and failing,
right,
that if I wanted to be a cartoonist, I needed to get my cartoon into another form.
Right, right.
So that's how I came up with the idea for Diary of a Wimpy Kid and a way to put my cartoons into books.
So now in 2007, with Harry and Abrams, Diary of a Wimpy Kid was in its print release. But before that, Diary of a Wimpy Kid was actually an online story which actually had about maybe 20 million children were actually reading it online.
That's right. In the first 2 years, there were about 20 million readers from
right.
all over the world. So that gave me a lot of confidence.
Right.
People liked what I was writing.
Right.
And that sort of predated blogging. So I was putting out a new entry every day, and I think people enjoyed that.
Yeah.
And they enjoyed seeing what I was going to come up with the next day.
And actually, to date, your online blog actually has at least a total of 80 million visitors, actually, and roughly about 70,000 children read Diary of a Wimpy Kid per day. So, you know, the rest is history, actually, because, you know, you've actually been listed as New York Times' number one bestseller. Now, the characters of this book, actually, this particular book, we can say, ranges, actually, targets children from, like, about 9 years old to, like, about 13 years old, like, you know, children
right.
who are in middle school. And the theme of this is actually this young kid who has like this diary, who
right.
and his mother gives him a diary. He says, no, you know, buy something that doesn't say diary on it,
right.
like journal or something. And he even says that, don't expect me to write their diary in, you know, in the beginning, which
right.
actually he ends up doing, you know. So now, how did this like whole idea come about, this character of Greg? You know, I mean, when someone writes a book or even does screenplay movies, they actually would like to do like their first project would be something that they can relate to. How does Greg relate to you in any way?
I think Greg's a lot like me as a kid at that age.
Right.
And sometimes like I am as an adult. He's got lots of flaws and imperfections.
Right.
He's not a fully formed human being yet.
Yeah.
So he's got a lot to learn. And
right.
I think most of the humor comes from him not being perfect or him having a flawed perspective.
And, throughout the book, you know, you have some other characters that, you know, you're dealing with issues actually that children relate to. Even like, for example, myself, when I was reading the book at 26 years old,
yeah.
and I'm reading about like Gregory's, like his blogs or his entries in the journal, I tend to reflect upon my childhood,
right.
like, you know, I mean, the younger days when going to middle school. Now, because, you know, we have like our East Indian audience is there, and here's one thing I always tell you, whenever you have like a motion picture and you can have Arnold Schwarzenegger, Tom Cruise in a film, when you give them a film or a story with one Indian kid in there,
yeah.
you know, that's what grabs their attention. So one character that stood out to me was Chirag.
Right, right.
Now,
right.
Chirag, how did you create Chirag, actually?
Right.
Is he based on somebody that you know?
He's not really based on somebody I know, but it's funny that you had mentioned that. He ended up being a very minor character in my
right.
books.
Yeah.
I actually grew up with a kid named Chirag.
Oh, really?
But he's not really related to this character. But my sister told me a story. She said on the first day of school, there was a kid who was so small
right.
in her kid's class
yeah.
that he had to stand to use his desk because he couldn't sit. He'd be too low.
Right.
And I thought that was funny. So I put those things together.
Right.
I would
right.
have a memorable character.
Right.
And Chirag was a good name.
Right, yes.
But it's funny you should mention that kids in India, you know, they're sort of rooting for
Chirag,
kids,
yeah.
For Chirag. But this book is actually dedicated to a kid named Pranav.
Pranav, yeah, wow.
Who is from New Delhi.
Okay.
And he passed away. He had an illness.
Is that right?
And we got to FaceTime.
Right.
But he was 12 years old, and he had this devastating illness that didn't allow him to eat.
Wow.
And so we FaceTimed on Christmas, and we must have talked for about an hour and a half. And,
really?
And we showed each other our homes. We made a real connection.
Right,
you know?
Right, yes.
And so, he was such a positive kid that I decided to dedicate this book to him. So Pranav is right.
Wow. So this book, The Long Haul, is actually dedicated to Pranav, and, you know what I mean, loving memory of Pranav. And, you know what I mean, Chirag being like an important character, like a minor character, but, you know, in Hindi, according to Hinduism, Chirag means light, and in Hinduism, light, well, of course, you know, in general, light is essential. Light, without light, there's no life.
Right.
So light represents the goddess Lakshmi, who gives prosperity. So I think that with this character of Chirag, the goddess herself has blessed you with much happiness and prosperity. So my question is that where do you get the motivation? Actually, after your first Diary of a Wimpy Kid, you had Roderick's Rules, you have Cabin Fever. What sort of inspires you each time when you come up with a new novel?
I think what inspires me is the fear of it ending. You know,
of
I've gotten
ending,
to do
yes,
all these
true.
Amazing things. I've gotten to meet 3 U.S. presidents. I've gotten to travel the world.
Really?
I get to go on these book signings where, you know, hundreds of thousands of people show up.
Right.
And I don't want it to end. And
exactly.
So that in and of itself is a motivation. But I love it when, you know, a kid who's never read my books reads them and gets
right.
turned on to reading.
Yeah.
And goes on to bigger and better things, actually. So that makes me happy.
And the funny thing is that you said that initially you never really wanted to be a children's author. You know, you wanted to be like a newspaper cartoonist. But now, what's the beauty about being an author for children? You know, putting the smile on millions of children all around the world.
Yeah, I think you've said it yourself. It's great to think that I could go to Sweden and I'll meet kids who have read my book, or Australia or New Zealand.
Right.
Maybe Pakistan or a place
exactly,
I wouldn't
right.
have gone, you know, ordinarily.
Right.
Now I have a connection with those kids.
Yes.
And even though we don't speak the same language, or even share the same culture, we share these stories.
Yes.
And they're the stories of childhood.
And you mentioned language, actually, where you know, not everyone may speak the same language. Diary of a Wimpy Kid, I believe, has been translated in over 90 languages, is it?
44, actually.
44, okay, right.
I wish it was 90. I think Harry Potter is up there.
Or Harry Potter is, yes. When I was reading this book, actually, I found a similarity to an old cartoon that I used to watch back in, you know, in the 90s. You may have heard of it, Doug. Actually, it was
yes.
like, yeah, that was where the main character, Doug, is like, you know, talking about his experiences. And then, you know, I mean, basically, you know, for the benefit of television, we're seeing those experiences come to life.
Yeah.
Was this, when you created Diary of a Wimpy Kid, was it like in some sense inspired by the cartoon series Doug?
It wasn't. I've seen a little bit of Doug.
Right.
But I think in a way, nobody invents anything new.
And right, that is
that
true,
you're
yes.
sort of you know, everybody's told the same types of stories.
Right, right.
And I think that the cartoonist who's probably been the most influential on people that have come after him is Charles Schulz.
Right.
I think everything after Charles Schulz is a little bit different.
He right, yes.
really changed the way that people read comics.
Right. And when you see this film, actually, like, you know, I mean, the screenplay for Diary of a Wimpy Kid now, you know, I mean, most of the children who have actually, you know, played the roles of Greg,
yeah.
Rowley, Rodericks, you know, I think that, you know, they were a little bit more comfortable with their characters after reading the book. Actually, the book served like a form of a script for them.
Yeah.
Now, what can you say about, like, the, you know, I mean, the actors? Do you think that they did justice in bringing the characters to life?
I did. I think that they really, those actors actually really inhabited the characters.
Right.
You know, on the page, they're really simple stick figures. But
right.
in real life, you have to bring a lot more dimensionality and humanity to it. Excuse me.
Yes.
So I think that they really did that.
Yes, indeed. I think, you know, I mean, and the movies were, like, major success. And now, you know, I mean, you being a father of 2 children, can you say that, you know, your 2 sons are somewhat your inspiration to continue writing, you know, because you want to write something that they will enjoy reading?
Well, my kids allow me to see childhood from a second
right.
Vantage point. And
right.
that's been great for me to see it as an adult looking in over their shoulder, I guess you could say.
Right,
and
right.
yeah, it's great. At this moment, my kids are right in the right age range.
Right, yes.
And, you know, it's really fun. It's rewarding. I got to read this book to them, and I knew this won't last forever where they'll both be interested.
Right.
But I got to experience that. It was special.
And in some sense, Greg, actually, you know, you said that he's like as described in the first book, he's like an unlikely hero, and you know, he has this like inspiration that one day he'll be famous. So in some sense, like for those kids who are considered to be wimps or something, I guess this book sends a message. It's like a sort of therapy, and in some sense it serves as a motivation to them.
Right, I think that kids can see themselves in Greg, and you know, a lot of books where there's children as characters or protagonists,
right,
the kids act heroically all the time,
right,
and they're brave or they're strong or they're popular or cool,
right,
and you know, that's not Greg, and I think that most kids don't have that kind of confidence, so
right.
I think that, you know, that's, I was trying to create a character that was relatable and realistic.
Very good. Well, Mr. Jeff Kinney, I have to say that it's indeed been a pleasure speaking with you in conversation. I wish that this conversation could go on and on because there's so much that you have to offer, especially to our young viewers. But in closing, I would like for you to like leave a thought with some of our young viewers so that, you know, they to be a little bit, you know, I mean, whatever they sure. inspired to do, may they follow the dream.
My advice for young kids is that if you have an idea, to nurture that idea, to really let it grow, because it took me a long time to see my idea brought to life. It took me about 8 years.
Right.
So if you have an idea, really nurture it and see what happens.
Very good. Well, I want to thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you.
So thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks so much for your great.
So for the benefit of our viewers who speak Hindi, and to the parents, Sare Matai Pitai, Christmas ki avsar ke liye, ye jo tohfa aap sabke bache, ye aapke Christmas list sabse upar hona chahiye. This should be the top on the top of your Christmas list, right? So this book has been dedicated to Purnav. So all my East Indian brothers and also my West Indian brothers for Christmas do purchase this book. And also, you know, I mean, it has been a pleasure speaking with the man himself, Jeff
Thank
Kinney. I
much.
Look forward to the upcoming books.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.